I interviewed 300 women for this study all across the country, mothers of daughters from the age of 3 to in their 30s, just to find out why mothering daughters in the 21st century is such a complicated task.
Being a single mother, my job sometimes comes first.
She answers me back a lot. I'm working on it.
Some of the issues we deal with is clothing, makeup, and restaurants.
And why is it that so often, as the mother of daughters, we second guess ourselves?
You give a certain piece of advice and you think it's going to lead them in a certain direction, and they end up going in the complete opposite direction.
As a parent, you want to keep them safe and strong, and so that you're bound to clash.
If you don't make rules, they lose respect for you as quickly as if you do make rules.
I don't want to raise a fragile daughter. I want her to be really prepared when she walks out into the world, not for college, next week.
I do think that my children are very proud that their mother has a profession, but I have my own guilt about it.
I'm still very watchful. I feel as watchful of them now as I did when they were young.
So the real question we have to ask ourselves is, are we creating our own monsters?
It's this tug and war that I don't know anything, she knows more.
She don't want to listen to me a little bit.
And she said, Mommy, I don't like the kind of grown-up you are.
It takes a different skill set to negotiate with daughters than it does sons.
It's so much more fun to say, oh, you're having a bad day, or let's just blow this off and go shopping.
I found in my study that 90% of mothers say that it's much more loaded to raise a daughter than a son. 80% asked if they were actually teaching their daughters the right values. And virtually all of the mothers said that mothering their daughters can last a lifetime.